Hey guys, today I am starting a new tutorial series about JavaScript ES6 on my channel. In today's world, learning ES6 will be one of your biggest steps for writing modern JavaScript. Even if ES6 is around quite for a while, it is still a popular topic to talk about because it has brought major changes to JavaScript. And in this introduction video, we are going to talk about what ES6 is, why it is important to learn, and some of the most important features that ES6 brings to JavaScript, which I will explain them later on my following videos on this channel. But before we begin, if you are here for the first time, consider subscribing for learning more about web development and also activate your bell so when I upload a new video, you will get notified. ES6 stands for ECMAScript 6 or ECMAScript 2015 because it was released on 2015. Well, this isn't really that important, but people are confused with those terms like what is ECMAScript, what is JavaScript, what is ES, so there is a confusion with those namings, so I will try to explain them now. ECMAScript is the base language for some scripting languages, including JScript, CoffeeScript, JavaScript, and others as well. In addition, there is an organization called ECMA, which does all of the standardizations for ECMAScript, which also includes JavaScript. So when a newer version of JavaScript being released, it's not gonna be called like JavaScript version 6, but it is rather called as ECMAScript 6 or much shorter as ES6. And the next versions continue as ES7, ES8, and so on. You can find more information about this topic on Wikipedia. I've put down the link below in the description part. So that's all about the naming of actually what ES6 is and where it comes from. But there is a more important topic that I would like to talk about. Why it is important to learn ES6 and why you should know it. There are a couple of good reasons why you need to learn ES6 if you are going to be a JavaScript developer. First of all, ES6 has major changes over JavaScript. Nothing is going to be the same after starting to write code with the features of ES6, and if you are familiar with JavaScript, like JavaScript ES5, which is the older version, then you're gonna like ES6 a lot. Other reasons are that ES6 brings solutions to some important issues of JavaScript and also extends it. Like for example, ES6 supports the class keyword, which haven't existed before in JavaScript, and that makes a lot easier to write object-oriented JavaScript. Also, one of the other most important reasons is that today's modern frameworks like React or Vue.js, they all support ES6 and actually we use them together. So if you are going to use these modern frameworks in your project, it's a good idea to be familiar with ES6 first. Now let's see here quickly some of the most important features that ES6 brings, and I'm gonna cover them in my following videos. And I'll also try to show the features with the same JavaScript, like how it was before ES6 and after ES6. So in the very next video, you are going to start learning the two new keywords for variable declarations that ES6 brings, such as let and constant. After that, we're gonna talk about arrow functions, which is also a syntax change to JavaScript functions. And then we talk about template literals, object literals, and after that, default parameters and the destructuring assignment, which is being used a lot. Some new array methods that ES6 brings, like for each map and filter functions, for example, which are really helpful in daily programming. And then we continue with classes. You should know it if you are already familiar with object-oriented programming. And then we move on with modules and finally promises, which I already explained in one of my other videos. I'm very excited to cover these topics on my channel very soon, and I hope you are excited too. So that's all for now, and see you guys in the next video.